Six of the company. Again, it's if you've gone through the memorandum of any company, how does it look like? First is the first is the name of the company, right? And then the place of business of the company. So we'll be taking up the change in registered office later. We are looking at the change of object clause. Now, every memorandum of company contains the main object clause, which is generally the third clause, which specifies that what is the objective for which this company is formed. It is one of the most important clause a memorandum contains, because it also identifies specifically in the changed GST era, where we have HSN code for every activity that a company is doing. So it is based on this main object clause that the government will identify whether a company is doing one business under the name or it is doing multiple business under one brand name. What used to happen prior to the 2013 era, students, there were many companies who were doing their businesses and they were doing multiple businesses under one name, which is not the correct thing. So if I have a restaurant business, I cannot say tomorrow I also need to open up maybe a theater or something, you know, or anything else, maybe a stationery shop or a tuition center or whatever, you know. If it is restaurant and hotels, it has to be restricted and limited to restaurants and hotel. Accordingly, my balance sheet, P&L, etc., whatever figures they are reporting has to come. The figures has to come or reported from the receipts which are being generated out of this business vertical and not from any other business vertical, right? So this lays down the foundation for a very steady and very steady and important from all angles, from income tax, from GST, from the company's act point of view, etc. So any alteration in MOA with respect to objects of the company is permitted through a special resolution under section 31. However, subsection 8 restricts the change in object when which has raised money through public prospectus and still has any unutilized amount of the out of the money so raised unless a special resolution is passed by the company, and the company prescribed details of such resolution shall be published in vernacular language and English language newspaper in circulation at the place of registered office of the company and also on the website of the company. The dissenting shareholders shall be given an opportunity to exit the company in accordance with the regulations of SEBI. The change in objects law shall be effective only on registration of special resolution. So why are we stressing so much on registration of special resolution, students? I hope by now you must have understood that every such change that I have told you happens in the founding documents of the company, but we can say preamble of the company, is has to go through the shareholders or the promoters of the company. So once the shareholders of the company, in case of a listed company, since the shareholders is huge, it is magnanimous count, it is always more than 100, 200, 500,000, etc. Because the number of shareholders is very large, it's very important to seek their approval. And to seek their approval, it is not an easy or a cost-effective method. It is expensive and it is time-consuming method, right? So that is why it is said that for any such resolution which is passed seeking the approval of the shareholders, we must tell or inform the registrar of companies and the regional director that yes, we have obtained that approval and then we are applying for the change, right? When we go forward, we'll realize how to take this approval. The company need to file with the ROC MGT 14 with a certified true copy of special resolution. Any decree against holding company, will it affect subsidiary company? In what context are you asking me, Sneha? Can you elaborate? Because this question will have not one connotation. It can be read from different angles. Of course, if you are asking from the angle of only name change and only object change, it will not affect the subsidiary company. The only impact that would come is in the subsidiary company, the holding company's name as a shareholder will change on the share certificate. but not as in decree or you know, anything in terms of litigation. The change in the objects of the company shall be effective only on registration of the resolution. Company need to file with ROC MGT 14, and the registrar shall register any alteration in memorandum with respect to object change and certify the registration within a period of 30 days from the date of filing. Right? Rajan, wherever the companies are listed, LODR requirements will have to be complied with. Every time there is a board resolution, there is a pre-intimation of board resolution, there is a post-intimation. So that means holding of the EGM or AGM notice has to, board meeting, the notice has to go to stock exchange. Once the meeting is concluded, within 24 hours, the outcome will also have to be filed with the stock exchange, because the members or the shareholders of the company are very eager to, you know what's happening in the company. So when we give any declaration to the stock exchange or file any notices with the stock exchange, the stock exchange website in itself is a window to the shareholders to understand what's happening in their company, where they have invested the money. So from that angle, it becomes extremely pertinent that all such requirements or all such things which are affecting the rights of shareholders at any given point of time need to be intimated to the regulatory body, that is stock exchange. Then for altering the objects, this is the procedure that we do, that is hold the board meeting. So issue a 7-day notice containing time, date, venue of the meeting and detailed agenda. Now the 7-day notice can definitely can be curtailed, shorter notice based on the consent from all the board members. Generally in private limited companies we do this, students. And secondly, what does your articles of association talks about the board meeting notice, length of the board meeting notice is of primary importance. Certain companies do make it 3 days or 2 days also. So it depends upon what is the length of notice provided. But if nothing is provided, we consider 7 days. Hold the board meeting, consider to pass the resolution approving the proposed amendments in the object clause. Consider and pass another resolution fixing date, time, etc. Approve the notice of the general meeting and draft resolution of the explanatory statement. Now, students, you will realize one very important thing in this whole chapter is about explanatory statement. What do we mean by explanatory statement, which is given under 102? Now, it specifies various information that must go to the shareholders along with the resolution which is proposed. I hope by now, because you all are in finals, right? By now, you must have realized that what is a resolution and what kind of content the resolution contains. Resolution is such a snapshot, or it's such a concise way of, making a decision or passing a decision of the board, that all information about that resolution cannot be carried within the resolution itself. So if a company is increasing the capital or changing its registered office, etc., there must be some underlying thought because of which the company is doing this. This underlying thought or reason why the company is going for it will be captured only and only in the explanatory statement. And that is why attachment of the explanatory statement is extremely important with all the documents like the notice of the general meeting and whenever minutes are being created, same explanation must go in the minutes of the meeting. Then issue notice of the general meeting to the company, all the directors, auditors, etc. Send copies of notice to the stock exchange. Hold the general meeting and pass the special resolution. Company having members up to 200 or not are not required to transact business through postal ballot. So that means without postal ballot, what does that mean? Without postal ballot would mean through a general meeting. And with postal ballot means there is no general meeting required, but you send the postal ballot forms and the shareholders will send it back, the duly filled in forms, whereby a scrutinizer will be appointed. That professional will check as to, what is the assent and dissent ratio. If it is majority of the members who has casted their votes in assent, which means in yes, affirmative, then the resolution will be considered as passed, and that the decision of the scrutinizer will then be intimated to the chairman and or MD of the company and to the stock exchange through the company secretary of the company. Right, so this is how the procedure will take place. Then intimate the stock exchange, send to each stock exchange a copy of proceedings of the general meeting, that is the minutes. Then file with the ROC MGT 14 with a copy of board resolution passed by the company with a copy of the explanatory statement. Within 30 days of passing of resolution, obtain from the ROC certificate of registration of alteration of memorandum. So, okay. Under MCA 21, the user may select get certified copy and follow the procedure. Amend each copy of MOA available with the company. Many times, students, it happens that companies change the memorandum because of the name or the object clause or the the capital of the company, etc., etc. But they fail to change or forget to change the memorandum article copies available at their office. Incidentally, we have come across certain practical experiences where we realize that companies are filing documents to banks for loans or any kind of overdraft facility or any other transaction wherever their memorandum is to be used, and they're filing a wrong memorandum because company is just not aware. This problem generally creeps with private limited companies who are not very law savvy, and neither do they have their personalized company secretaries to guide them at every step, right?